Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to show you how to connect to an EC2 instance in Amazon AWS. So I am at aws.amazon.com. I go to my account. I was already logged in, so it takes me to AWS Management Console. If you are not logged in, you will be prompted to log in. Then you put your username and password to log in. That will take you to AWS Management Console. I'll create a new EC2 Windows instance. So go to EC2 under Compute. And then I launch a new instance. I'm using a free tier account, so I select free tier only, and it gives me all the free tier EC2 instances that are available. Now I'm going to choose the Windows Server 2016. And the instance type that is available under free tier is a T2 Micro. So I go next. Here I have to use the public IP address. Amazon can automatically assign a public IP address. I have to make it enable. The public IP address allows me to connect to an EC2 instance over the internet. Other settings can be default. Shutdown behavior stop means when I shut down this Windows Server 2016, it will stop the instance. There's another option which is called terminate. That means if I shut down the machine, it will remove the instance as well. For now, I will keep it as a stop. And later, after I finish using this instance, I will terminate it manually. So go to the next page. Here's the storage, which is the hard drive for the Windows Server machine. Then I go next. I can add some tag. You can easily find an item by using tag. So next, security group. To connect to a Windows instance, you need remote desktop connection. And this is gonna be my first instance. I can select an existing security group or I can create a new one. There is an existing security group, which is the default one. I can choose that one, or I can also create a new security group. A security group basically allows you to apply different security policies. The security group that I have allows me to connect over the internet from anywhere. I made some changes in this security group before. So let me show you a new security group. So I'm going to create a new one. I need an RDP type of connection to connect to Windows machine. There are many other options, but to be able to connect to a Windows machine, I need RDP. So I keep RDP. In the production environment, you should restrict the IP address from where you can connect to specific IP. Because this is a test environment, I'm going to keep it as anywhere so that I can connect from anywhere, not only from the IP where I am connecting right now, but I can connect from my workplace, my home, from anywhere. But this is not a secret configuration, as it allows a connection from any IP. So in production environment, you should restrict this source to specific IPs from where you will be connecting. So I review and launch. Gives me warning that the security group allows connection from anywhere. So I select launch. Now I have to create and save a key pair. It is very important that you keep this key pair with you and save it in a secure storage to be able to connect to this instance, you need this key pairs, and later you cannot download this key pair anymore, so you must save it now. Download. I'm going to save this key pair in my local storage whenever I need to connect to this Windows Server 2016 instance. So it is saved. Next, I launch the instance. It's going to take a few minutes to launch the instance. Please note that there is a public DNS. This public DNS will be needed to connect over the internet. Or you can also use a public IP. To connect to this instance, I can use remote desktop on Windows 10. So my instance is ready to run and I can connect to this instance. Next, I will need to generate a password to log into this instance. So I go to Actions and then get Windows password. Then I need to choose the key pair that I saved on my local computer and decrypt it to get the password. And then decrypt. So the username is administrator and the password has been generated. I'm using Windows 10, I can use remote desktop connection. Or there are many other remote desktop software that you can use to connect to a Windows machine remotely. So I run remote desktop. I copy this public DNS. Copy. And I paste in there. And in option, I put the username, which is administrator. And enter this password. So it's asking me for the password. Okay, and prompting to connect, say yes. So first time you log in with an account, it creates a profile and it takes a few minutes to create the profile. So I am inside Windows Server 2016 and connecting to remote desktop. I can configure this server as I need based on the role I want it to perform. To add and configure the roles that you need. So I'm not gonna configure any role in here, but you can see that there are many roles this server can do. Now I can shut down this Windows Server machine and it will take me back to Windows 10 environment. So come back to Windows 10 environment. Lastly, I will go to the instances that I have. I'm not going to use this instance in future, so I will terminate this instance. The instance is selected, so go to the action and then from instance state, say terminate. It also gave me the warning that I will lose the storage that is connected to this instance, so confirm the termination. and it will take few minutes to finish. So it shows that the instance has been terminated. And that is the end of this demonstration. I hope you found this video helpful. If you would like to receive notifications on future videos, please make sure you are subscribed to my channel and set up notifications by tapping on the bell. Thank you for watching.